Welcome to our YouTube channel. In this video, today I am going to discuss what is the TestNG, what is the benefit of TestNG, and how we install the plugin TestNG in Eclipse. So let's start now. So TestNG is a testing automation framework. This is a Java-based framework, which is inspired from JUnit as well as the NUnit, with introducing some new functionalities that make it more powerful compared to both. And this is very easier to use. TestNG, here TestNG means the next generation. This is advanced of the JUnit. That's why we can say this is the next generation. There are multiple benefits provided by the TestNG over the other unit framework like JUnit as well as NUnit. With the help of TestNG, we can generate the report into HTML format, XML format. It will generate the report after the execution of the test script. We can group the multiple test cases in a single, by grouping. And with the help of using that group, we can run on that particular group of test cases. So multiple test cases we can group in TestNG. Same test cases we can execute on multiple times without using loop. So it provides a data provider that is used for data-driven approach, where we can use that data provider to perform the single test. We can execute the single test on multiple set of data. So that will also help here for data-driven approach. We can implement the data-driven approach very easily, and all the test cases. This is one test case for all the test data that will execute independently. Means if your test script getting fail any particular data, that will not impact on other test data execution. Similar type, like it will also provide some additional suite concept, like where we can create the TestNG suite XML file, and we can group the multiple XML TestNG classes file and execute in single command. And here also we can pass some parameters with the help of using TestNG suite XML file, and those details will pass into the test script. Using this feature, we can run one test cases on multiple environment. TestNG suite will also provide some features by which we can execute the test cases parallelly, sequentially, as well as we can execute one test in multiple instances. So these features will be provided, and we can easily implement with the help of using a TestNG suite XML file. TestNG can be easily integrated with the Maven, Gradle, Jenkins, and other CI tools. There are some dependencies TestNG provides, so we can make the test cases dependent. So one test case will dependent on other test cases. So in that case, if one test dependent test will fail, then other test will automatically fail. Skip. This is very easily to integrate with the Selenium WebDriver, because Selenium WebDriver is not its own reporting. Then TestNG will help to write the test cases with the help of TestNG annotations, as well as we can get the report which is generated with HTML report. There are some listeners provided by the TestNG. Those listeners we can override and create the very nice report. There is a parameterization option provided by the TestNG. We can parameterize the values from the suite XML file and then can pass to corresponding test script. This is supported by a variety of tools, and it will provide also plugins like Eclipse, IDE, something. So we can install the plugins, and then the TestNG option will be available. It has its own assertion libraries. With the help of using that, we can verify the expected and actual values. So these are some benefits which are provided by TestNG. Now let's move on the how we install the plugin into the Eclipse. So first time when you download the Eclipse, then by default TestNG is not installed. So we need to check, we need to install the TestNG. So there are two ways we can install the TestNG plugin in Eclipse. One is with the help of using the marketplace. Second is by using the URL, its URL. So let me first show how we download the install the Eclipse with MarketSpace. So how we know that testng is not installed? So if I go here, like suppose that if you right click any package, new Java program, click on Java class, go to again here, new, click on the, go to other. Then if the testng is installed, you will get the testng option will be listed here, like similar Java, Gradle, Git. So currently I am not getting the testng option, that's why, because the testng is not installed in Eclipse. Now let's go and check how we can install. Go to the Eclipse help, go to the Eclipse work marketplace, click on this, you will get one pop-up that will appear here. Yeah, once it will ready, we need to search testng and click on install button. Go to search, first click on go button. This will search the testng, right? Now I'm getting here testng for Eclipse. Click on install button. After the download, we will get here the option testng, and these are we are getting here. One is testng that is required. Let's select both. Just click on this checkbox if not selected. Click on confirm button, and then it will start installing the plugin. Click on the accept radio button, then click on finish. Click on the install anyway. When you get this pop-up, now this will install. Installation is started here. At the bottom, you can see this one. Once the installation will complete, it will ask to restart the Eclipse. Click on the restart button. After the installation, Eclipse will completely install. Plugin will install in your Eclipse. Now Eclipse restarted successfully. Let me add the plugin here. So what we need to do, we can create, you can check also by creating the test. Go to here, other. Here now I am able to get the testng option. Go to your test, add the testng notation like @ test and any Java file over method. Click on this, you will get add library, right? Now I can add this. This will be added here. Mouse over, now I can import the testng class. Now done. So this is the one way we can install the Eclipse plugin by using the marketplace. We need to go here, Eclipse marketplace, click, and then search the testng and install the plugin. Now there is another way. Let me show you. Open testng.org. This, go to here, Eclipse. Here installation. In first step, you can see, follow the instruction, click on install button, this one, and here you will get the URL. Copy this URL, this complete URL. Go to your helps, click on the Eclipse, like new install software, this. You will get here, click on add button, testng 112. So you can give just name. I'm giving testng 12, and then here paste the URL. So make sure you can remove the this HTTPS, add the HTTP. Click on add button. Once you will add, that will be automatically reflect here. And the test similar type when we are installing the plugins using Workspace, that at that time it was loaded and displayed under here. So we can see here the testng plugins will displayed here, and then we need to select, click on that, click on next button, but currently this is already installed, so that's why I am not giving the enable ops next button. But yes, if the testng is not installed in Eclipse, then we will get next button, and then need to follow the same step we've done previously from the while installing the Eclipse from Workspace. So in this way, we can install the Eclipse. Hope this will help you to get understanding of like what is the TestNG, what is the benefit, and how we install the plugin in the Eclipse. In next video, we will discuss more related to TestNG concept. And thanks for watching the video.